Hello there! You're watching Wilhelm Miniatures. In this episode, I'm going to try to resin cast a potato. Lately, I have been very inspired by Turnip 28, so I thought I should make some root terrain. This is the potato that I used to texture my turnip troll a little while ago, and it's starting to become a little bit soft and get some growths on it. It still doesn't have any mold, so I can still use it to add texture to things, but I don't think it's going to live that much longer. So, right now it's actually quite nice looking because it's got all these wrinkles, which is a very nice texture. So I was thinking that it might be possible to save these by casting it in resin and make it into a terrain piece or maybe even a tool that I can use. So the experiment here is basically to see if it's possible to make a mold and resin cast of something that's soft. I have cast organic materials in the past, like bones, teeth, and snail shells, which has worked out perfectly, but of course they are hard materials. So let's see how this will go. I'm going to make a blanket mold for my potato, as I think that's the easiest thing to do. So I have to decide how to orient it in space, and I think as these growths are pointing a little bit in that direction, I think the pouring opening should be here so that I could possibly catch these flowers or growths. I might not be able to cast these growths, but at least pouring in this direction will have them pointing downward, which gives me a chance. First, I need to make some kind of stand for my potato, and I think it's enough just to make a wire spiral like this and stick my potato upside down onto it. So now I can cover the potato with the silicone, and while it cures I can just leave it like this, and I can might have to cut a little bit of the opening down here, but that should be fine. I left my silicone covered potato to dry, and now it's time to open the mold and see if it worked out. Okay, I'm not going to get this one out without doing any cutting, which is a bit of a problem because this is a blanket mold and not a box mold. So finding a way to keeping the mold closed when pouring resin will be challenging. But I think this part here is the thickest, so I'm going to cut along the thick part to have a good place to close it. And I want to cut as little as possible. One thing is that, of course, if I get some rubber bands on it and it starts to distort a little bit, that's not the biggest issue, because after all, this is a potato. So if the shape gets a little warped, that's not going to be a problem. Of course, this wasn't really the thickest part, it's just where we had the little plant thing, which I would very much like to cast. So that was, that was a bit unlucky. Anyway, I'm going to try to fill this with some resin, and then I'll come back to see how it looks. All right, I've filled it with resin, so let's take a quick look at the potato cast. All right, here we are. Wow, the detail of the growth actually turned out pretty good. Even the tiny, tiny hairs are present. And of course, the nice potato texture is perfectly transferred. Wow, that's pretty cool. Okay, here I have a very nice looking resin potato. But the question now is what to do with it. I think the most obvious thing to do would be to make it into some terrain piece for my Turnip 28 project. However, as my turnip project only consists of one huge monster so far, and yeah, no real infantry miniatures or anything, I think it's a little bit early to start making up terrain for it. On the other hand, I have my Nurgle Dark Mechanicum project, which is starting to have quite a lot of units and characters. So I was thinking that maybe I could use this potato for for them, maybe make some kind of objective marker or terrain piece for my Nurgle miniatures. And that's going to be very fitting because if I paint this wrinkly potato skin as more of like a kind of organic human-ish skin color, as this one has already got, I think this is going to look like a weird lump of flesh, or maybe some kind of birthing pod or something. Right, that's a start. It does look a little lonely being on this large base all by itself. So I think adding some Leka balls will be appropriate. And again, these are the kind of balls that you get for your garden. I think they're for draining purposes or something. Anyway, they all look like small organic lumps. They actually look like small potatoes. So adding a few of these around will be appropriate. So here I have some leftovers from the various miniatures I have built so far, and let's see if some of them can be used. Creepy arm to make it into a great unclean one or something instead. That would be a fun challenge to make a potato great unclean one. But I think I'm going to save that for another time. I want this one to be a terrain piece. Right, it looks a little bit empty back here, so I'm just going to put in some pearls just to have some texture before I add the regular dirt texture of the base. Maybe some electrical wires too, just to be some extra details here and there, and also to increase the sci-fi look on this one. I primed the potato thing with a zenithal highlight using black and then white from above. And yeah, already we can easily see all those nice potato cracks a lot better now that it has some color variations than before. I'm going to paint this similarly as I painted the skin on my Nurgle Dark Mechanicum 4, so I will be using mostly contrast paints. Here, I also have two of my Dark Mechanicum Nurgle miniatures that I will have close by so that I can keep an eye on them for reference. Anyway, to start off, I'm going to add a little bit more white because the spray is not actually pure white. The Corax white is a little bit off-white, and also when it's sprayed on top of black, it doesn't become as bright as it can be. So here, I just have a big flat brush and some white, and I will give it a rough dry brush just to really bring out all of these potato textures. What I like to do when using contrast paint to paint organic surfaces, I like to just open a range of paints like this so that I can mix and match them directly onto the figure. I think I want to start with this kind of yellowish thing, maybe with a little bit of green, because that's of course super nurgly. Some brown down here, have it darker towards the bottom maybe. Some of the purple. Purple and brown is going to be a very nasty color. And all the way down, maybe some red. Oh, the red is so intense and I forget every time. So every time I slap on the red, it just becomes very, very bright red. Anyway. And then, before everything has a chance to properly dry, I like to dab the surface with a piece of tissue. This blends everything a bit better together, and it also shows the white highlights through. So it's not dry down here, but the tops are starting to dry. So I think I can move on to the highlights. I'm not going to go too much into details in this episode because this one is of course more about using a potato to make something fun than, you know, painting Nurgle stuff. So if you want to see how I paint my Nurgle stuff in general, you should check out one of my painting videos, which is, there I go really into detail on every step of the process. Anyway, this is of course a terrain piece objective marker thing, so I'm going to rely more heavily on dry brushing for the highlights. And dry brushing textures is of course a lot of fun, and also looks very nice, and it's super simple, so yeah, it's no need to spend too much time painting your terrain pieces. Sometimes you can really get away with some shortcuts. All right, with a few more washes and highlights, I finished painting this potato. I also add a little bit of red and purple here and there to break it up a little, as it was very green and kind of blended in with the base. But now I think it looks good, and I think it's very fitting with my Dark Mechanicum miniatures. I hope you enjoyed watching the process in this video. If you did, please like and subscribe to my channel. And if you would like to see more of my projects, you can find me on Instagram and Facebook, which I will link below. If you would like to support this channel, please feel free to visit my Etsy store and Patreon. That's it for this time. I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye.